morning and Jai Hind children, welcome to GK class. Today in GK class we are going to do page 27, 28 and 29. In the previous class we have completed up to page number 26 and I hope you all have completed up to here in your GK book. So children, let's start today's class. Take out your GK book and get ready with your pencil in your hand. Okay, so let's start today's class. So children, first I am going to show you PPT. Through it, I will first explain you the topic and then we will come to the book exercises. Okay? So your first topic is polar habitat on page number 27. So all of you take out page number 27. See the screen all of you. Okay? Polar habitat. Now here we will learn about what is polar habitat. Okay, what is polar habitat? See, the polar regions are two snowy places at the top and the bottom of the earth. It is so cold, trees can't even grow there. So children, you all have seen earth. Sabne earth dekha hai na? This is the picture of earth. Now you can see this is the picture of earth. So, the upper area of earth and the bottom area is known as poles. They are very colder region. They are very colder region. They are covered with snow throughout the year. Okay? They are covered with the snow throughout the year. And not even there you will find not a single tree over there. So, it is so cold that trees can't even grow. So these regions, your upper region is known as North Pole and the bottom region is known as South Pole. So these are the polar regions. They are covered with snow. They are very cold throughout the year. They are made up of two places called the Arctic North Pole and Antarctic South Pole. So see children, the North Pole, the northern part is known as Arctic and the southern part is known as Antarctica. Okay, so the upper part, the northern part is known as Arctic and the southern part is known as Antarctica. So how many poles are there? There are two poles. One is northern pole, another one is southern pole. Northern pole is known as Arctic and southern pole is known as Antarctica. Okay, now see, there are lots of animals in the polar regions and they have very thick fur, so they don't get cold. Some of the animals you may find are penguin, Arctic hare, Arctic fox, seal, polar bear and snowy owl. So in this lesson children, we are going to study about the animals that are found in these polar regions. We have to identify those animals. See, there are even some people who live in the Arctic regions. They wear lots of warm clothes and can sometimes build houses using the snow and ice. So now you all know na, houses that are made up of snow and ice is known as igloo. Yes, people live inside the igloo. It keeps them warm. Okay, so the houses that are built in the poles are igloos. Okay, many people live inside igloo and we are going to study about the animals that lives in these areas. They are covered with thick fur. Unke upar bahut thick jo hai fur hota hai. They are very furry. Why they are furry? Because it keeps them warm. We children, when during the winter period, winter what we used to wear, we used to wear those types of clothes which keeps us warm. So these animals, they don't have clothes to wear. So they are naturally, they are provided with thick fur so that they can adapt to the climatic condition in the poles. Okay, so they can live comfortably in those regions. What types of animals live in polar habitat? Now see what types of animals can survive there. Animals in the polar region survive in these very cold lands. The temperature can drop to 50 degrees below zero. Zero se bhi niche temperature wahan pe hota hai. Aur jab zero se temperature drop karta hai, drip karta hai, to it goes into minus. Jab zero se upar jata hai, it goes to plus, positive. Yes, and when it goes from below zero, it goes to negative minus 50 degree Celsius is the temperature in the poles. That is why it is covered with lots of ice. Ice is, you can find ice only at the freezing point, that is 0 degree Celsius. Par usse bhi jab niche jata hai, to it remains ice and cold snow throughout the year. Okay? Now say which animals lives in the polar regions? Penguins, walruses, Arctic foxes, seals, polar bears, huskies, reindeer, sea lions and Arctic hares. These are some of the animals which are adaptable to these climatic conditions and they are found in the polar region. Ye sare animals hain jo polar regions mein humko mil sakte hain. Okay? So now I am going to share you the book exercises. Okay? So everyone get ready with the book exercises. Polar habitat. Take the animals that lives in polar region and cross out the others. So now, right now I have shown you the animals that can survive in the polar regions. So you have to put a tick mark on those animals that can survive in the polar region. Whale can survive in the polar region? Yes. So you put a tick mark. Put a tick mark on your picture one. Number two, polar bear. Yes, polar bear can survive in the polar region. See, through the polar only you can understand that they can survive in the polar region. They are having very thick fur that protect them from the extreme cold that you will find in the polar regions. Okay, now see, third picture is of elephant. Elephant can survive in the polar region? No, they are not adaptable to that region. Their structure, their creation is not adaptable, suitable to the polar region. Okay, so they are not adaptable. So put a cross on elephant. Now fourth picture is of Arctic fox. Now Arctic fox can survive in the polar region? Yes. So put a tick mark. They are adapted to polar habitat. So put a tick mark. Then comes the Arctic wolf. Now through the picture only you can understand, see and understand that they are very furry. They have a thick fur that is covering their body. So they can survive in the extreme cold that is there in the polar region. So you will put a tick mark on Arctic wolf also. Then come macaw. You will put a cross. They cannot survive in the polar region. They are not adaptable to the polar region. Now see, it is written millions of people inhabit the Arctic, but Antarctica has no permanent residents. So people avoid living in Antarctic regions. Okay, so people don't survive in the Antarctic region, so they avoid their residents in the Antarctica. Okay, so this completes your page number 27. Now come to the page number 28. First, before starting the book exercises, I want you all to see the PPT. Okay, so first I will show you the PPT and then we will move on to our next lesson, next page. So your page 28 is, your page 28 is literally literary felicitations. Literary felicitations is also known as, what is the meaning of it? Now, do you know what is the meaning of it? Literary felicitations means the award given for the good work in the literature. Okay? So, there are many prizes that are being awarded for the good work for the people, to the people, those who contribute good in the field of literature. So your first is, I am going to explain, is the Booker Prize. Now see why the Booker Prize is given and who deserve this prize. See, the Booker Prize for Fiction, formerly known as the Booker McConnell Prize, means its former name was Booker McConnell Prize, and the Man Booker Prize is the literary prize awarded each year for the best original novel written in the English language and published in the United Kingdom. Okay, so it is given to those novels which are written in English and it is published in United Kingdom. So if a novel is written in English and it is published in United Kingdom, then if it is very good, it is given Booker Prize Award. Okay, this Booker Prize Award was earlier known as MacConnell Prize. Okay, so it is a literature prize. It is given for good literature and it is awarded each year for the best original novel. Now comes the next prize, is the International Man Booker Prize for the year 2020. Was announced this Wednesday on 26th August. It was awarded to Marit Lucas Rignewald for her debut novel, The Discomfort of Evening, translated from Dutch by Michelle Hutchison. Okay, so this is the International Man Booker Prize for 2020 was announced on 26th August. Only the this 26th August, which is just passed on Wednesday. And to whom it was given? It was given to Marit Lucas Rignewald for her debut novel. Debut means the thing that is done for the first time. Okay, so the thing, the novel she has written, it was her first novel. She is doing debut in it. So she was given this prize. Okay, The Discomfort of Evening, translated from Dutch by Michelle Hutchison. So she has translated it. It was originally written in Dutch, but she has translated it in English. Now see, we come to the next prize, that is the Pulitzer Prize. Pulitzer Prize for Fiction is one of the 7 American Pulitzer Prizes that are annually awarded for letters, drama and music. So Pulitzer Prize is given for letters, drama and music. And it is annually awarded, means it is given in the once in a year. Now which country gives this award? United States. Ceremony date? This year was 5th of May 2020. So this year it was held on 5th May 2020. The first award, the Pulitzer first award was given in 1917 and it was presented by Columbia University. It was awarded for excellence in newspaper journalism, literary achievements and musical composition. So, it was given to the people who are eminent in the field of newspaper journalism, literary achievements and musical composition. Now, we will study about the Guardian First Book Award. Why it is given and to whom it is given? See, the Guardian First Book Award was a literary award presented by the Guardian newspaper. It annually recognized one book by a new writer. So if a new writer is coming, if he is writing his first book, then this Guardian First Book Award is given. It was established in 1999. So in which year it came into existence? In year, it started from year 1999, replacing the Guardian Fiction Award. That means earlier it was named as Guardian Fiction Award. But now from 1999, its name is changed and it is Guardian First Book Award and it is given for the first book that is written by the author. If he is doing first time, he is writing a book, he is awarded. If it is a good book, he is awarded Guardian First Book Award. And that the newspaper has sponsored from 1965. Okay. Indian-born American physician Siddharth Mukherjee's Pulitzer-winning biography of cancer, The Emperor of All Maladies, has won the $10,000 prestigious Guardian First Book Award, beating 4 formidable contenders. Okay, so see, in this year, who has won this award? American Indian-born American physician Indian born Dr. Siddharth Mukherjee has won this Pulitzer Award for writing biography on cancer. Okay, the Emperor of All Maladies. This is the name of his book. This book has won $10,000 prestigious Guardian First Book Award. There were four contenders, there were four competitors whom Siddharth Mukherjee has beat to win this title. Okay. Now come the National Book Foundation. Okay, the mission of National Book Foundation is to celebrate the best literature since 1950. So when it was started? It was started back in the year 1950. Sarah M. Broom accepts the 2019 National Book Award for Nonfiction. Okay, so it was given last National Book Award that was given was in 2019. And who was the winner of it? Sarah M. Broom was the winner of this award, National Book Foundation. Okay, so it was given to National Book Award was given to Sarah M. Broom. Okay, National Book Award was given to Sarah M. Broom. It was established by this mission, this award was established by National Book Foundation to celebrate the best literature. Jo bhi bahut achha literature hoga. Do you know what is literature? Literatures are the work done in English. Okay. Work done in any language, whether it is poem, it is story, it is novel. So, these all are literature. Now, the Nobel Prize in Literature. Why it is given? Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize in a literature is a Swedish literature prize that is awarded annually since 1901 to an author from any country. So, it is not that he belongs to UK, he belongs to USA, then only this prize is given. Nobel Prize in Literature is given for the people who has done good work in the field of literature and he belongs to any country, wo chahe jis bhi desh ka ho. Okay, if he has done a very good deed, a good work, then he is given Nobel Prize in Literature. Okay. And this award has started since 1901. 1901 is read as 1901 to an author from any country. He is a writer from any country. In the words of the will of Swedish industrialist Alfred Nobel, produced in the field of literature the most outstanding work in an ideal direction. So, if a person, he perform an outstanding work in literature, he is given this Nobel Prize in Literature. Okay. It is a Swedish Literature Prize. And it is awarded annually. That means once in a year. All the awards that we are studying which are given in the field of literature are awarded annually. Ye saal mein ek baar hi diye jaate hain. Now, see, the Nobel Prize in Literature 2019 was awarded to Peter Handke. Okay, so Peter Handke was the person who was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature. You can see this is the Nobel Prize in Literature. It was awarded to Peter Handke in 2019. So the last Nobel Prize winner in literature, in the field of literature, was Peter Handke. So this, the last Nobel Prize in Literature was given to Peter Handke. Now comes the Hugo Award. Hugo Award is an annual literary award for the best science fiction or fantasy works and achievements of the previous year given at the World Science Fiction Convention and chosen by its members. The Hugo is widely considered the premier award in science fiction. So basically this Hugo Award is given for the contribution in the science field. For the writing, for the literature that is done in the science field. Okay. So, it is awarded for science. Good work done in the science. It is also an annual literary award. That means it is given once in a year. So, Hugo Award is related to science. So, if a literature is written good in science, then a Hugo Award will be given. Now, children, this completes your page 28. Now we will do the book exercises. Okay. Now see the book exercises. Literary felicitation. Okay, now take out page number 28. Now we'll do the book exercises of literary felicitation. In this lesson, we are going to read about the various awards that are given. Okay, we have just seen the PPT. Now we are going to do book exercises. So in this lesson, we are going to write the name of the awards which are given in the field of literature. Okay, so writer of a full length novel in English language from a Commonwealth nation, Ireland or Zimbabwe, write down Man Booker Prize. Okay, so your first is Man Booker Prize. Their work should be done basically in English language, and it should be, the person should be from that country only. Now see the US award for achievement for those in newspaper, magazine or online journalism, literature and musical composition with 21 categories including journalism, letters, drama and music. So I've told you na, Pulitzer Award is given for the achievement in the field of newspaper, journalism, literature, music, composition, drama, letters. Okay, so which US award is given for all in for person who are eminent in all these fields? Pulitzer Award. Okay, so what is the spelling of Pulitzer? Here T is silent, Pulitzer, but you will read it as Pulitzer Award. T becomes silent. Okay, now comes to the third award given to the first time authors of English fiction and non-fiction books. So first time author who has written his debut. Okay, so who has done his debut? So this award is given to a debut which is known as Guardian First Book Award. Okay, so if an author has written first book and his very first book has done very good work in the field of literature, he is given Guardian First Book Award. Now see the fourth question. US Literature Prize awarded in four categories: fiction, non-fiction, poetry and young people's. Now children, do you know what is the meaning of fiction and non-fiction? Fiction is which is true, which is reality, and non-fiction means which has no connection with reality. Okay, so poetry and young people's literature along with two lifetime achievement awards. Okay, so US Literature Prize awarded in four categories is National Book Award. So this is the award which is given to the young people who came up with a very good work in literature. Okay, and who has also achieved two lifetime achievement awards. Now see a prestigious literature award given to an author for their outstanding work. So which is the prestigious literature award which is given to an author for their outstanding work? Nobel Prize for Literature. So if a person, he does very good work in the field of literature, he is given Nobel Prize for Literature. Award given for science fiction. Now we have studied na, science fiction ke liye kaun sa award diya jata hai? Hugo Award. Yes, so award given for science fiction or fantasy, and categories include best novel, best graphic story and best fan writer is Hugo Award. So if it is given science fiction, then you will write Hugo Award. If it is given prestigious literature award, then you will write Nobel Prize. Okay, if it is given that award given to the first time, then it is Guardian First Book Award. Okay, and if the award is given for the field of poetry, young people's literature, then that is National Book Award. Okay, so this completes your page number 28. Now I will again show you the PPT of page number 29. Then we will discuss it and then we will come to the book exercises. Okay, so let's see the PPT all of you. Now your next lesson is mythical creatures. In this lesson, we are going to study about the various mythical creatures. Okay? Now see children, what is the meaning of mythical creatures? A mythical creature can be described as a creature thought not to exist and possibly possess mystical and or magical powers. For example, a unicorn. So children, you all have seen many movies, many cartoons in which these mythical creatures exist. Many stories you all have read about. Yes, many series you all have seen, like in Harry Potter also there were many these mythical creatures were there. Yes, so mythical creatures are what? What are these mythical creatures? Mythical creatures are the ones who does not exist. Matlab wo real mein nahi hai. They are just a piece of thought. Wo sirf hamare ek kalpanik चीज है. ओके, इट डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट. वो सही में रियलिटी में नहीं है, बट इट हैज कम इन एग्जिस्टेंस थ्रू आवर माइंड. ओके, सो इट इज जस्ट अ कल्पना, यू कैन से. ओके, इट्स नॉट अ रियलिटी. दे थॉट नॉट टू एग्जिस्ट एंड पॉसिबली पोजेस मिस्टिकल एंड मैजिकल पावर्स, एंड दे आर हैविंग मेनी मैजिकल पावर्स इन देम. ओके, so one of the example of mythical creatures is unicorn. Now I'm going to show you the pictures of various mythical creatures that you all have seen in various movies. You all have seen it in cartoons. You all have seen them in various series. Okay, so now see a phoenix. First we are going to study about a phoenix. What is phoenix? A phoenix is a mythological bird. So it is a mythological bird that cyclically regenerates or is otherwise born again. Cyclically regenerates means it gets birth again and again. वो वापस से बार बार जिंदा हो जाते हैं. So they are known as cyclically. This is what cyclically regenerates means. Okay, associated with fire. So they are associated with fire and the sun. So they symbolizes fire and sun. A phoenix obtains new life by arising from the ashes of its predecessor. तो phoenix किस में से निकलता है, किस में से arise होता है? It arises from the ashes. Ashes you know, राख. Ashes of their predecessors, जो उनके पहले जो उनके पूर्वज थे उनकी ashes में से वो फिर से जन्म लेता है. Okay, it gets rebirth. Now your next is creature, mythical creature is Yeti. Yeti, you all have heard about that. These are still in some of the stories you will find that Yetis are there in Himalayan regions of India. Many people have seen these Yetis in Himalayan regions. Okay, they are still not in reality. They are just imagination. The Yeti is a monstrous creature. The entity would later come to be referred to as the abdominal snowman in Western popular culture. So in India they are known as Yeti, but when you go to Western countries they are known as abdominal snowman. So they are also mythical creature, one of the mythical creature. You all have heard they are having existence in many of the stories in Panchatantra. Okay, so they are one of the creatures which we found in our mythological stories. Then come the unicorn. Where many of you have purchased, nowadays you can find these unicorns. They look many toys are coming unicorn. Then you can find them in pencil boxes. Girls are having these types of boxes, pouches, purse. So this a picture of unicorn is there. So you might have seen a horse having a you can say having a sing. उसके सर पे एक सींग सी होती है, horn. Okay, they are having horn at their forehead. Okay, so they are unicorn. Now see werewolf. Werewolf in European folklore, a man who turns into a wolf at night and devours animals, people, or corpses but return to human form by day. Now in many cartoons, in many movies, in many stories, you all have seen that there are some creatures जो दिन में इंसान की तरह होते हैं और रात में वो क्या बन जाते हैं, they turn into animals, वो wolf बन जाते हैं रात में. Either they turn into wolf, they turn into various different types of animals. So these are the werewolf. Okay, they transform themselves at night. They changes into other creatures and in the daytime they again came back to their original form. वो दिन में फिर से वो अपने original human body में वापस आ जाते हैं and रात में they turn into ferocious werewolf. Now comes the vampires. Now you all have heard about vampires, yes? Vampires जो होते हैं वो क्या करते हैं, blood suck कर लेते हैं. Now see, vampires are undead creatures, so they are not dead really, that often visited loved ones and caused mischief or deaths in the neighborhoods. जो अपने loved ones हैं उनसे मिलने जाते हैं and they kill human. They inhabited while they were alive, okay? So they suck the blood from the human body. They are vampires. So they are also mythical creatures. In many of the film you all have seen these vampires. They are wearing that black color coat, yes, and they are having long teeth, red eyes. Now comes the dragons. Dragons are among the most popular and enduring of the world's mythological creatures, okay? Now we come to our book exercises. Now I will show you the book exercises. You can see the picture of dragons. Now we come to our book exercises, okay? Mythical creatures. Identify these mythical creatures and write their names using the help box. So in the help box the names are given. Now you have to identify them. We have already discussed about their features in the PPT, so it's easy for you to identify them. This is the picture of a phoenix. It is related to fire and it symbolizes sun. Okay, so write down the spelling of phoenix. If phoenix is pronounced with F but it is written as P-H-O. Okay, phoenix is written as P-H-O-E. But it, when you speak it up, it you will say phoenix, F, F is sounding, but starts with P-H-O-E-N-I-X. In the next picture, you will see this is the picture of a yeti, Y-E-T-I. They are mainly found in the Himalayan regions of India and the places which are covered with snow. Unicorn, this is the third picture, okay? This is one of the mythical creatures found in many of the stories, in you can see in books and novels, movies also, and in cartoon characters. Then comes the werewolf. This is a picture of werewolf. So write down all of you. Now your fifth picture is of vampire. Okay. Then the sixth picture is of dragon. Now dragon throws fire from its mouth. Yes, it imitates fire. Now see, mythical creatures are the ones that are made famous in folklore and myths. Conclusive evidence of their existence is yet to be found. So they are just a piece of our imagination and they do not exist in reality. Wo sach mein nahi hote hain. They are just a piece of our imagination. Okay. Now see children, according to legend, phoenix is a bird that is reborn from its ashes. I have told you that phoenix is reborn, regenerated from its ashes. Now children, this completes your book exercises. Now I'm going to show you few of the GK questions. We are going to discuss current affair topics and then we will see. Okay, let's see. Which is the biggest continent in the world? Which is the biggest continent in the world? So you all have read it. Asia is the biggest continent of the world. Which is the largest continent in the world? Russia. Which country is the largest country in the world? Russia. In terms of area, Russia is the largest country. Which is the smallest country in the world? Vatican City is the smallest country in the world. Which is the largest bone in human body? Femur. Thigh bone is the largest bone in the human body. Which is the largest island in the world? Greenland is the largest island in the world. Which is the longest river in the world? Nile. Nile, which is located in Egypt, is the longest river in the world. Which is the largest desert in the world? Sahara Desert is the largest desert in the world. So children, this completes our today's class. This completes our classwork. I hope you all have understood the content that is being taught you today. So I'm sending you PDF file through which you will complete all your classwork. Okay. So children, I hope you all have enjoyed today's class. We will meet again in our next class. Till then, goodbye and take care everyone.